fantastic. Miss USA.
Thank you.
All right. So your year is coming to a close very soon in May. You've had an amazing, amazing year. Tell me about it.
It has been amazing. It's been life-changing. I don't want it to end. I enjoy the opportunity to be an ambassador for the Miss Universe organization and to really talk all about things I care about, especially in the STEM world for the children. I've had the opportunity to travel to Colombia. I've competed with 93 girls. I've been to the Philippines. A lot of us are friends now. We're all going to plan a trip to Hawaii soon. I love this nomadic lifestyle, and I'm glad I have a platform that's able to talk to little girls and tell them you can be anything you want, and you're here to change the world. Be yourself, be confident, and just love who you are.
Let's talk about that, because you have been not only had a chance with this platform to spread that message, but also spread a message about a new program that you have created on your own to encourage more young girls out there to get involved in STEM, or in some cases STEAM, which includes the arts. Tell me about that.
And I really want to tell you thank you for highlighting the fact that I have started on my own. And it was self-funded originally, and with a lot of, you know, hard work and connections and reaching out to people, I was able to get Facebook on board, as well as Bechtel Services, Excel Services, the Capital T's from DC, the DMV Hydration, like the list goes on. But these people all saw the vision in the program that basically helps children that are intimidated by math and science subjects to fall in love with these subjects. So my program, Science Exploration for Kids, we have after-school programs, we have tutoring, and we do career prep and readiness and exposure for the middle and high school students, because we understand that children are natural-born scientists. They look at the world around them with inquisitive eyes, and they're able to channel certain areas in their brain to fix things, to alter things, but now we want to put it in a more controlled setting and help them realize that you can be the next scientist, IT person, next person building the next artificial intelligence. So the world is really transitioning into tech, and we incorporate the arts in our program so that children can have more visuals and have fun while they're learning.
They're natural explorers, which is one of the portions of your, of course, what your program is called.
Yes. Yes.
So I love that. I also love that you're getting them early. Because a lot of people always assume that, oh, some kid may not be good at math or may not be good at science. And sometimes they say maybe a teacher didn't teach them well. But it's I think more of it is exposure, first and foremost, more than anything else.
I totally agree with you. And it comes from a personal space as well. I wasn't always the best math student either. And it was the way the material was being taught. So I learned through the way that I tutor. I help students find what they're more so struggling with, but I like to use the term area of improvement. So sometimes some students just don't understand algebra that well, or some don't understand reading comprehension. So when we start them, like you said, like at a younger age, so we're doing programs for first through fifth graders. And through these after school programs, we show them the techniques that they're learning in the classroom, and then just transition them and parallel them with a really fun science experiment that makes it relatable. And one thing I use, like I used to start off first with all my elementary school students, is a plate of milk, and you put food coloring in the middle, like you stack them all on top of each other, like four drops of like three different colors. Mm-hmm. Take a Q-tip with some dish soap on it, and then put the Q-tip right in the middle of your plate, and then all the colors like disperse everywhere, and it actually is like really visually beautiful. So when you go home, try it. But what we do is we basically tell the students, like, a soap is a surfactant. So we give them the layman term, and then we give them the scientific term, and we're saying that the soap and the milk, everything is hydrophilic. So essentially, the molecules are bouncing all over the place because the soap is breaking down the fat in the milk. So you make it relatable. It's like, I'm like, does anybody wash dishes in here? And they're like, yes. I'm like, I know you use a dishwasher, but this is what's happening with soap when you're scrubbing. And you're just breaking down the fat molecules. And they're like, oh, that makes so much sense. And we do the same thing with like fractions. We make everything so simple and layman because the stuff isn't difficult, but it gives you so many career opportunities.
You give science and math a new way of looking at it. You make it fun.
Yes.
And when things are fun, people, especially kids, are like, I'll do that, right?
Absolutely. And I think that was why, that's why I started the program. I went on to study chemistry, not really knowing what I was getting myself into. Mm. I just knew I was good at chemistry in high school. I liked it. Something about understanding stoichiometry really intrigued me, and I was able to go to college for free, but I didn't know what career opportunities were available. And, you know, you don't know what you don't know, you know, so it's like you have a lot of mentors in place to help you. And that's what the program does. We like to pair them with industry leaders, government officials, researchers, professors, and we have students have the opportunity to see everything that encompasses a science degree, an engineering degree, a tech degree, and give them that exposure so they're able to see where they fit best.
And these are also, you're preparing for the next generation of the inventors, the scientists, the engineers. Those are going to, basically, those are the kids who are going to create things for us to get us into the next centuries and centuries to come.
Absolutely. And one thing that Science Exploration for Kids is working on for the next summer is an entrepreneurial program where we help students. They're put into teams and they're going to find like a real world issue or something that they want to tackle an event in the science and tech area, and they're going to fundraise and get people on board to, you know, back them and build whatever they need to build, put together the app, so, and they're going to be able to pitch it. But this is giving students, you know, that financial responsibility as well, and then they're learning just certain life skills that I'm not sure if they're still taught anymore in the school settings, but it's just certain life skills, even like writing checks and putting yourself in a space to be like a boss, a supervisor, and you're taking a hold of your career at a younger age.
How does it feel? I know you know that you're a role model, but how does it feel to be almost breaking down stereotypes of what a pageant contestant or pageant girl is? Because you are Miss USA. We see the title. You are also a scientist. And yet people would be like, well, those two things don't seem to go together, but in so many ways they do. Explain that.
They absolutely do. So breaking the stereotypes, of course, didn't necessarily realize I was doing it initially, and so there was like a lot of highlight behind my career path. And I only did what I only saw growing up, which was a hardworking woman who was in the military, who was a contractor, then became a federal government employee. So I did what I saw and what I knew. And, you know, when all the press went out, like, oh, she also works for the Nuclear Regulatory Commission and she's a scientist. It's empowering to know that there is a paradigm shift in the pageantry world and people are also taking heed to it. Because women, we're natural born leaders, and at times we have to be, well, in the past we've always been very, very timid with our approach to a lot of situations because we don't want to come off bossy, but we are bosses, you know, like it's okay to be aggressive in your career. So having that paradigm shift from pageantry and science, I'm glad so many other young girls are able to like finally see it, and not only see it in television. There's a real life Barbie doll out here that likes to wear lab coats, likes to go rollerblading, loves math, loves to tell students about it. And now we're showing that scientists are the new heroes, the new celebrities. Why do you think Instagram exists? Why do you think cell phones are here? It's because of scientists and tech people. And of course, a lot of aesthetics in there as well. That's why you have the art component. But that's the whole thing. We're like showing why the world is really going round. And we're making these people into celebrities. And I'm thankful that I'm able to be a part of that as well.
That's pretty cool. Now, speaking of which, because yes, you, once you pass along your crown to, well, you get to keep your crown, but another person becomes Miss USA, you still have a lot of things I'm sure you want to do. So give us a glimpse into the future of what you plan on doing after the next Miss USA is crowned.
Look into my eyes. I'm going to tell you everything. I'm joking.
I love that. That was good.
So let's see. Your question was, I kind of got distracted.
That's okay. That's, I love it. Distraction and fun time and yeah, laughing. That's okay. What we do. That's what we do.
Right.
Okay. So basically, glimpse into, yeah, what do you plan on doing? What do you want to do with not the rest of your life, but, you know, after this chapter of Miss USA closes, which it doesn't really close. You always have the title. But what do you plan on doing now?
So the beauty of life is we have options, and I've been making sure options are available. So my science program, I've been putting my blood, sweat, and tears into this because I know the benefit that children get when they come into this program. And I saw that firsthand at my inaugural event in D.C. on March 24th, and kids were just so entranced by math and science. And the thing is, they knew so much about it, and that's what really warmed my heart, and they were happy to be there. Of course, I'm going to like definitely look into the public speaking area. I've done a lot of panels with the American Nuclear Society. I've been invited by a few other engineering leagues, and as well as like NSBE to do a couple of things, but like schedules don't permit everything all the time. So a lot of my work is going to be definitely surrounded around my civic engagement in my STEAM program, Science Exploration for Kids. But if there's an opportunity, you know, in other areas, we're just going to keep the options open. But my blood, sweat, and tears have been definitely put into the science program.
I love that. I see so many wonderful things coming your way, not only just with this program, but just opening the doors to how beautiful studying the sciences are, the technology, engineering, art, and math, and how it basically makes this world go around. Yeah. Because without it, I don't know if we'd be able to, we wouldn't have the computers we have. We wouldn't be able to do this YouTube show right now. We wouldn't be able to do so much.
I agree.
But there's still more that we can do.
I agree. And I think that's why I'm more intrigued by science. And people are always like, well, do you want to go into modeling? I'm like, it's not that I don't. I've always been the kind of behind the scenes person. Mm-hmm. I love to understand, you know, how this camera works. Every time I'm on a plane, I'm always mesmerized, because you think about this huge mass of an object that's like floating in the air. Mm-hmm. And it even amazes me more that, you know, the Wright brothers, when they first made the airplanes, people were like, you're crazy. It's not going to happen. I think they started out with wood at that,
they
you
did.
Know? So
yeah.
It's amazing, because you see the transition and the shift in science and tech. And it's always that one person that challenges the status quo and has other people thinking differently, and then everyone goes on board. And then there's different derivatives of what everybody wants, but that's the beauty. And that's why we have like four different cell phone companies, you know, different camera companies. It's just, it shows that it's a wide market, and, you know, a lot of students can get involved in it.
I love that. And of course, before we go, because I know I just talked to you for a long time. I could talk to you for hours.
Let's
because
do
you're
it.
Just, well, you have other things you have to do. I totally get that. But you also do a lot of volunteer service, not only with, of course, your program being the way that it is, but also you are here right now for Dress for Success Houston and partnering with CHI and inspiring women, not just with science, but also with this program. And tell me just briefly about why you're here at Dress for Success Houston.
Absolutely. So as Miss USA, we work closely with the CHI company, Farouk Systems, because they are one of our sponsors. And we're here as ambassadors on behalf of them, because we understand that you only have one time to make a first impression. And programs like Dress for Success and CHI being here is what helping many women, you know, come into their confidence. Dress for Success is giving the women the resources to go into interview rooms, to be into boardrooms, and letting them know that it's okay to start over or have a transition, and it's okay to know that you're not alone. So that's why I think this program is amazing. And I shared my personal story about being a scientist in the government and how I came to work on my first day in a black suit, black skirt, black shirt, Lord. But but it's okay to be confident in your colors and your hair. And that's what CHI is providing as well. So they're an amazing sponsor. The products are amazing. I love the Deep Brilliance line, and their lava technology really helps out too. I actually wear my hair naturally curly usually, so one of their curling wands helped me match my natural curls on top just to give that perfect tame, and then I spray like a little Deep Brilliance shine spray.
I love it, and I saw you practicing with it out there too. So
yeah.
One final question, because I know you got to go.
Sure.
If there's one thing you could tell people to get out there and give back and do something for others, what would you tell them to do?
So,
or how would you tell them? Because some people can't, they don't know what to do.
Absolutely. Google is an amazing tool. I will also say give back in areas that you know that you may have been struggling or lacking it with at one point in your life. Or give back in areas that you have seen people affected in certain areas. And it's all a personal preference, but giving back is what's important, because we wouldn't have what we have today if it wasn't for one man. You know, so it's like you have to make sure you're giving back in any area, to, because there's people out here who don't have the same opportunities as we do. And I've seen it as being a military child, growing up in Japan, traveling, you know, to Korea. You see it, and having family in South Carolina. Not everyone has the same opportunities, but give back as much as possible, because the world needs your strength, the world needs your energy, and they need all the advice you have to give as well.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for your time. I appreciate it. Congratulations on everything that you've accomplished so far, and you have so many more wonderful things coming your way. I can see it right now.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, and I'm just going to blow some sugar.
Woo! Thank you for blowing some sugar for me. I appreciate it. Bye, everybody.
Bye.